Welcome to this very first session on MuleChain introduction. MuleChain is a custom connector for MuleSoft applications, and we are going to open source it very soon. It is based on Langchain4j, which got created as an open source project and has been inspired through Langchain and Llama Index and other frameworks as well. So we take a very similar approach here for MuleChain. MuleChain will be mainly based on Langchain4j. We are going to use the libraries and so on, but we will also add additional capabilities on top of MuleChain to really allow the MuleSoft users to use Studio or Code Builder to build autonomous agents. So MuleChain has three main areas. The very first one is really about easier interaction with LLM and vector stores. This is all the benefits Langchain4j is providing to us. So we are fully leveraging everything we have here. The second one is optimized for Mule application. Very similar to what Langchain4j does to Java application, we have created this connector to get the same experience into the MuleSoft application, but also allowing users to benefit from all the different pre-built connectors MuleSoft is providing to SAP, to Salesforce, to ServiceNow, and many, many more. So this is something where you can use MuleSoft capabilities together with MuleChain and Langchain4j capabilities. And the last one is all about AI services, RAG, tools, chain, and so on. So again, this is coming from Langchain4j. We will provide operations as part of the custom connector to allow you supporting AI agents to be created. But also in terms of tools, what we will or we are working on is the access to the AnyPoint org, where all your Exchange tools or APIs are published, and this agent is going to then connect to Exchange platform through a defined filter and have access to certain tools which it can use throughout its execution. So that's basically the framework itself. But before we go into the demo, I just want to also highlight what Langchain is basically enabling here. Or MuleChain. So it's about the end-to-end lifecycle of autonomous agents. So that's really not only through the connector, but through the platform capabilities of MuleSoft AnyPoint platform, we are able to now design agent specifications in AnyPoint platform, prototype it, mock it, share it in Exchange, and then using this connector, we are going to build workflows, design our AI agents in AnyPoint Studio, test it with MUnit and deploy anywhere in Cloud Hub, on-premise, wherever you feel like it's the best suited environment. Secure the interaction through API management, operate it in Runtime Manager, Visualizer, monitor your agents, and publish and reuse through internal as well as external portals. So that's basically what gets enabled just by building this MuleChain custom connector. And now before I go into the demo, let's quickly have a look what I already did, because I want to follow this life cycle and share as much as I can what the fundamental concepts are on designing and governing autonomous agents. So now let's take a look at Design Center. I've built this simple design specification for an agent I want to create. The agent is all about a simple one, sentiment analyzer. I've created here a resource where the agent can be accessed through a post method. It has a response body, which I created, as well as a body, which is it is accepting here. The text to analyze, and those things, the data types I've created separately. So really simple, providing a prompt, this is the text to analyze, and we are returning the result, which is the sentiment. I've also published this agent in Exchange, so everyone can see how it behaves. Other people can collaborate here and use and provide feedback. So now it's the time where I will import this agent into AnyPoint Studio. So here I'm in Studio. The first thing I need to do is I need to import this sentiment analyzer. So let me say, let's say 00, so it's on the top. Sentiment analyzer. Analyzer, and I will import the published API from Exchange. Sentiment. So it found it here. So I can now import this agent specification into AnyPoint Studio. Click on Finish, and now it will scaffold everything for me. And here we are. So I will just minimize these two console. We are really focusing on the development. So the first thing to build this agent is I need to install the custom connector. That can be done by adding the dependency. So the moment it will become available on GitHub, you can download it and install it in your Maven repository locally. Or even publish it into your Exchange as a connector is also a possibility. But now, currently, this is a version, MVP version, which we will be using here. And now it should be available in the MuleFlows. So here you can see it is here, the MuleChain connector. So we will go through all those operations. There will be more operations provided once the connector is released. But today we are going to really focus upon the sentiment analyzer, which is even a pre-built operation we are providing. So we will provide pre-built operation for certain use cases which are more generic, but also give examples how for industry specific use cases, classification can be created using this connector. Anyway, we are providing the overall set to also define prompt templates, which could also be a classification operation you could build in terms of having a specific customer service classification to analyze a case and categorize it automatically. So those types of things can be easily implemented generically, but we will also focus on pre-built operations which are already ready-made. So let's first of all get this operation into our flow. So I will edit here. This one I can delete. And at the end, we would probably have a transform component. And now this thing is easy to configure. So let's take a look here. The first thing I need to provide is I need to provide a configuration for the LLM, which I'm going to use. So I can click here on plus. And if I open the list, I should see the different LLMs which are currently configured. So the moment we are going to release it, there might be more. But this is not a big step to add additional ones. Currently, we want to really focus on the functionality and quality of the delivery. So that's why we have just four. And you can switch easily between those four. So if you want to move to Mistral AI at some point, or Ollama, or Anthropic, you can easily do. You can get started with OpenAI. And here, I'm going to use the API key, which can be used for LangChain4j, which is simply demo. So as we are using the demo, the LangChain4j framework in the background, this will probably work. And now in terms of defining the data, here what I would do is I would just say payload, and we can say it will be a prompt. Yeah, it has to be a prompt because this comes from the specification. And once I have the text, I can translate it back to JSON and say this is the result we need to provide, and the result is just the payload itself. And that's it. Now I can run the agent and save it here. So let's see how it will be deployed. and we can then use it using Postman. Okay, so the app is deployed, and let me open the console to test it out. So we can see we have the analyze method here. I can click on post, and now I can provide the template or the prompt which I would like to analyze here. So let's say I had a great start into the day. So let's send it. And it should respond. This is positive. So I had a not so good, bad start into the day. So this is, you know, you can even analyze it, but there are text, and let me grab one like this one here. So a simple, I've noticed that you've been missing deadlines. It affects our overall productivity, and I believe that you can do better. To improve this, let's work on settings more realistic to schedules and sticking to them. It can be coming from a feedback portal or a form or even an email you would like to analyze. So here you can get, you know, for larger text as well, the sentiment defined. It's a simple example, but that's the starting point where we can use case MuleChain already. And now imagine you have built your workflow here in any point, and at some point you decide to move to Mistral AI or combine OpenAI and Mistral AI. Then you have the possibility to add a new configuration. This time it would be for Mistral, and you could easily switch the Mistral configuration between OpenAI and Mistral. So that's one thing. We are also providing, as part of the configuration, the models. Currently, it's a flat list. We are going to fine-tune it a bit. So the available models are available here as well. But anyway, it's a text field where you can enter the model of your need or even use the parameterization options in any point. Studio, where you can provide the model even as part of the payload. Okay, so once this agent is built, you can now deploy it to Cloud Hub, and that can be done also directly from here. And I will do it, and in some later videos we will be talking about the operational part and the monitoring part for these agents. So that's all for today. I hope I could convey the message of MuleChain and how we are thinking about it to further leverage AI with this unification layer for LLMs and vector databases.